नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, srimahans, mahans, kotaris, tanedars, sitting with us all over the world through Nityananda TV, Sadhana TV, and two-way video conferencing, having Nayanadiksha. Cities sitting with us, two-way video conferencing, Harris Plains, New Jersey, Surrey, Canada, Los Angeles, Hollywood, Nityananda Nagara, Rajabalayam Adhinam, Kuala Lumpur, Palani Adhinam, Nityananda University, Paris, Hong Kong, Sirgadi, San Diego, La Jolla, Indrani, New Jersey, Seattle, Chidambaram, Toronto, Adhinam, Surrey, Canada, Columbus, Sri Lanka, Guadalupe, Rameshwaram, Houston, Kalahasti, Amersfoort, Netherlands, Premayananda, Dubai, Warrington, UK, Los Angeles, Petam, Hyderabad, Guptakashi, Oklahoma, Somanatham, San Jose, Madurai, Ohio, Prayag Temple, more cities are joining. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. Last few days I am just soaked in Cambodia temples. Before entering into the satsang, let me remind all of you, today is Mahaparinirvana Day, the day my biological father achieved enlightenment and left the body. I think as per the Hindu calendar, Tithi, Punya Tithi, we are observing this festival, this ritual. Punya Tithi means the day they left the body. The day is called Punya Tithi. So as per the Vedic tradition, exactly on that same Tithi, we are observing this Maheshwara Puja, not only for my father, all the devotees, disciples who lived Jivan Mukti, who were striving for Jivan Mukti, initiated disciples who lived Jivan Mukti, for all of them today we give Shraddha, we give Pindadarpana, and we are doing Maheshwara Puja. The best place on the planet Earth to give Pindadarpana is the stomach of a sannyasi. That is the Jadaragni, the hunger fire of a sannyasi, is the best fire on which you can offer the Pindadarpana and Shraddha, which reaches the Pitrus directly. It is 1,000 times more greater than offering any Pinda, any Shraddha in any river, any water body, any tank, any lake, any holy land, any holy place. Offering it in the stomach of sannyasi is the best form of Pindadarpana and Shraddha I can challenge in this whole world. You will never find this many number of authentic sannyasis anywhere. I guarantee you with my name. This many sannyasis authentically authentically living. I am telling you, I have lived in all monasteries. I have stayed in many Christian monasteries. I have stayed in many other religious monasteries. I have stayed even in many Hindu monasteries. With all this authority, I am telling you, this many number of sannyasis authentically living Advaita, you will find only in Dhyanapitam. We are the place where the largest number of sannyasis are living the highest possible authentic living Advaita. And the way they handle their each problem and solve it just only by Advaitic understanding. Understand, I am a too powerful perfectionist, taskmaster, trainer. That's the right word I have to use. Too perfectionist, powerful, taskmaster, trainer. Even the same result I want, I will not allow them to achieve using some other method or technique other than living Advaita. Not just the goal, even the path, I won't compromise. See, for example, living a simple life. If somebody is living a simple life because of their poverty consciousness and stupidity, from the young age they believe they are poor and their life is going to be poor. Out of that pattern, if somebody is living the poverty, I will not accept that as a simple life. You will see automatically the situation will happen in such a way their desires will be aggravated, their greed will wake up. Only if they come to the conclusion and decision of a simple life because of Advaitic understanding. Tena tyaktena bunjita makrita kasya siddhanam. By renouncing everything, celebrating everything. This is the Advaitic context of renunciation. By renouncing everything, celebrating everything, I will let them rest in peace and live even humbleness if they understand this right context. Not till then. Everything they do, even if the goal is as we want, as desired, I will not keep quiet or tolerate and accept or adjust. I'll see to it even the understanding path, the reason why they are perfect is also perfect. Only then that perfection will be perfectly perfect and be eternal. If that perfection is achieved by wrong reason, it will never be eternal. If somebody achieves simple life out of poverty consciousness, I challenge. The moment he gets easy money, all his simple life will disappear. If somebody lives a simple life because of this grand understanding, tena tyaktena bunjita makrita kasya siddhanam, celebrating everything by renouncing everything, isha vasyam mitam sarvam yatkincha jagatyan jagat tena tyaktena bunjita makrita kasya siddhanam kurvanneveha jijivishecha dagun sadaha. Whatever is by renouncing celebrate it. By renouncing the idea of I and mine, celebrate whatever is. Not just the end result, even the context. Again and again and again, I bring it to living Advaita. That is why I am telling you. You will find so many sannyasis all over the world, no doubt, who are living the same result, who are as simple as my sannyasis and as dedicated as my sannyasis, as pure as my sannyasis. But I tell you, this one thing with a lot of bliss, I can challenge, not out of ego or arrogance. With a lot of bliss, I declare. No need even to challenge, I declare. You will not find a sannyasis who will have so many right reasons for what they are and who they are, why they are, the way they are. That I can be very sure, because the amount of understanding given to them, the amount of knowledge transferred to them, the amount of experience transmitted to them, the amount of right things shared with them, the amount of the right knowledge showered on them, with that almost spending 15 years on the sannyas training and 37 years of me being directly trained by my gurus and by my great disciples. I had a training and reverse training, both. After being trained 37 years in sannyas by my gurus and by my disciples, by various organizations and traditions, I have to tell you guys, I don't feel shy at all to tell this. I got training and initiation in various sannyas sampradayas of Hinduism. In so many sannyas sampradayas of Hinduism, I had a training and initiation. He doesn't belong to Advaita, he doesn't belong to Shaiva, he doesn't belong to Siddhanta, he doesn't belong to Vedanta, because he did that also, he did this also. But history cannot be hidden. History is history. I have had training and initiation in multiple sannyas sampradayas of Hinduism, because I had so much of passion, intensity to explore every sampradaya and collect all the best things from every sampradaya. I tell you guys, all the best things, whether it is the way my sannyasis dress, or the things they eat, or the way they live, whether the lifestyle practices like kriyas, yoga, mental understandings, knowledge, the way they solve their problem, the way they approach themselves, others, world, life, human beings, the Sangha members, everything, I tell you. I have collected the best flowers from all the sannyas traditions and made a beautiful bouquet. That is my sannyasis. That is my sannyasis. All the best understandings. For example, the extreme love and devotion of Ramayat Sampradaya. And the extreme purity and fire, Advaitic fire of the Suddha Vedantis, Suddhadvaita Vedantis, and the extreme renunciation, the way they handle their body purely from Aghoris, and the way they sing the kirtans, bhajans, music, the way the music and dance is celebrated is from the Gaudiya Sampradaya, Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya. And the way they constantly repeat and maintain the space of Shivoham, Shivadvita Sampradaya. Rama belonged to Shivadvaita Sampradaya. Shivadvaita Sampradaya originates from the Shiva Gita given to Rama by Mahadeva. From that Shivadvaita Sampradaya originates. The bhakti and prema of the Ramayat Sampradaya, the music and dance of Gaudiya Sampradaya, food and clothing style of Shaiva Sampradaya. I have taken the best flowers from all the gardens, great gardens, and made the bouquet. That is my sannyasis. I am telling you. Even my sannyasis do not know they have had so much training. I have collected the best flowers from almost all the sampradayas. The best flowers from almost all the sampradayas. Shaiva, Vaishnava, Madhva, Advaita, Suddha Vedanta, Suddha Advaita, Shankara, Siddhanta, the best things from all the sampradayas I have collected, because I myself personally went through training in most of these sampradayas, and even had formal initiations in many of these sampradayas, and saw the extreme experience, the goal of those sampradayas from those contexts. With this clarity, I am telling you what Ramakrishna said, Yadomat Tatopat. As many faiths, so many paths is true. I just want to add only one line. As many faiths, so many paths, no doubt. But there are some paths in which you can only travel in bullock cart speed. There are some paths you can just take off like a jet. That I want to add. Understand? That is why I am saying all paths lead to the same goal, but not in the same speed or the same comfort. All paths lead to the same goal, but I don't want to say all paths are same. Sampradaya, order, each sampradaya is created with one context and one goal. I tell you, our sannyasis are living the best context and the best goal and best authenticity. Today, we will be having Maheshwara Puja, giving Shraddha, Pindadana to all the disciples, devotees of our Sangha, who strived to live enlightenment and lived enlightenment, who lived these great teachings and left the body, for all of them, today we will be offering Shraddha and Pindadarpana Maheshwara Puja in the form of Maheshwara Puja. Today, we also have Nitya Yoga Teachers Training. And I tell you, when Vedantis see my sannyasi's body flexibility, they can never accept our sannyasis as Vedantis, because Vedanta is somehow identified with a big belly and very unflexible. It's unfortunate. It's not that all Vedantis have a big belly, and that is not true. There were many Vedantis, great yogis, but commonly. And Saiva Siddhantis can never tolerate when they see the joy radiated by my sannyasis. And they can never understand or accept my sannyasis radiating so much of joy. Because each sampradaya is created with a different context and different goal. Here, I have collected all the best contexts and the best path and the best goal, made it into most user-friendly, easy to live, easy to radiate, because putting the context first, once the context is understood, the life is simply lived. No teaching should be practiced. What is the meaning of the word practicing? Means you wanted, understood, this is right, but still you are striving, struggling to live that completely. That is what is practice. Practice is a decent word to show your irresponsibility to live the truth as it is. Your stupid failure to live the truth from the moment you understood it. That is why I don't believe in practice. I believe in understanding the right context. The moment you understood the context, you are living it. And you are loving it. That's all. The moment you understood the context, you are living it and you are loving it. That's all. Authenticity. Authenticity means what you like in your private Facebook page, liking the same thing in your day-to-day life and showing it to the world as you are like is authenticity. I am giving a new definition of authenticity. What you like in your private Facebook page, where you changed your name and you kept a secret profile, in that private Facebook page, what you like, in that private Facebook profile, what you like, liking the same in real life also, is authenticity. This is the definition of authenticity for the modern day youth. Today we will have the Maheshwara Puja. I have so much to tell about Cambodia. Time only is so short. I'm full of Cambodia temples now. And I've even started picking up many of the designs from Cambodia temple and started inculcating into our temples, which we are planning and building all over the world in our Sangha. To that extent, I am full of Cambodia temples now. And we also are going to have in Cambodia there is a special temple built only to give Shraddha to ancestors. We will plan and have one Maheshwara Puja in that same temple. And our Swamis are already sitting in Cambodia organizing the event to make it as a grand celebration of Shivoham. Celebration of Shivoham. Already all the arrangements are done, the basic arrangements. Now, beautifully expanding. And doing. Understand, I'm getting overwhelmed when I remember these Cambodia temples because I don't know which one to speak and which one not to speak. There are some carvings which is 70 miles long. Please understand. 70 miles long. 70 miles long. I am not able to understand how did these guys do it. Because we are also carving 7 feet, some 70 feet and all that. And how did these guys manage 7 mile? All right. It's really important we revive Cambodia temples. As I said, already we started working with the Cambodia government, committing with them that we will install deities and bring the temple back to Cambodia. Please understand, as of now it remains to be just a monument, tourist attraction. It is not a living temple. We are working with Cambodian government, at least few temples. We will install deities and revive it, make it as a living temples and show what a living Hindu temple means to the world. It's our responsibility, we will do it. Our responsibility and we will do it. So, with this, I bless you all. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching and causing eternal bliss. Nityananda. Thank you.
നിത്യാനന്ദ ധ്യാനപീഠം, നിത്യാനന്ദ നഗർ, ഓഫ് മൈസൂർ റോഡ്, ബിഡദി, ബെംഗളൂരു. ഫോൺ 0802727999. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.